Hi, Shimmy Shakers, and welcome to my first video tutorial. I will be releasing quite a few videos over the next few weeks, so please click on the subscribe button below if you'd like to be notified of when they come out so that you can learn lots of new moves. Now, the most impressive move in belly dancing. Today, I'm going to be teaching you the basic shimmy. The reason why I say this is the most impressive move in belly dancing is because you can learn so many different and complicated belly dancing techniques. But whenever I'm dancing at a restaurant or even a wedding, the move that gets the most claps, the most cheers, by far, is your basic shimmy. I've had some really beautiful experiences dancing at restaurants where the drums have been going slowly and then they're getting faster and faster. At the same time, I'm doing my shimmy slowly and they're getting faster and faster. And then the crowd, they're clapping, they start slowly, they get faster and faster. And by the end, everyone's screaming, everyone's cheering, I'm doing my shimmy really fast. And there's so much energy. These are the moments that I live for in my dancing. They make me so happy. Now, with your basic shimmy, it's really important that you do see a proper belly dancing teacher if you have not learned this move before. The reason for this is that, firstly, the basic shimmy is the basis of so many different moves in belly dancing, so it's really crucial that you get it perfect from the outset. The second reason is that if you don't have proper posture while you're belly dancing, you can injure yourself. So please make sure you see a proper teacher and that they help you with your shimmies and any moves that you're learning in belly dancing. But if you have already learned your basic shimmy through a teacher and you would like to see some tips and tricks that I use to extend my shimmy, then you'll enjoy this video. So, with our basic shimmy, there are quite a few different types of shimmies. There's your shimmy where you're kind of vibrating in your legs like this, so it's quite small, so you can see from the side my legs are just a little bit like this. There's your shimmy where you're moving your hips up and down, so it's really, really big. There's shimmies that have been taken from other dance styles, for example, reggaeton, where your hips are moving back and forwards really fast. And then also Tahitian dancing, where you're doing hip circles really, really fast. The shimmy that I'm going to teach you today is more of a classical Egyptian shimmy that I really love, so I hope you enjoy it. Now, let's begin with good posture. So, we step our feet hip width apart. If you haven't got a mirror in front of you and you're unsure what hip width is, a little trick, you can put your heel to your toe and then just turn your foot around and that will be hip width for you. The other thing is that you want to tuck your pelvis in. So some dance styles, they have their pelvis out. With belly dancing, we always want to be tucked in, nice and tall, strong posture. You can have your hands out or on your hips. Now, one nice way to learn your basic shimmy is through your knees. So for the moment, forget about your hips. Keep your posture strong and just bend one knee and then bend the other. One and then the other. Then you get faster and faster. And then you go fast as you can until you get into your basic shimmy. Now, you might find that you can pick this up straight away, but find it really hard to hold it, or you might find that you just can't get it at all. Now, this is very normal. You're using muscles that you don't normally use. It's a different type of fitness, but rest assured, the more that you keep doing it, the better and stronger your shimmy is going to be. With all of my students, I always say, try and find any excuse to shimmy. So if you're just doing your dishes at home, you can always do them while you're practicing your shimmy. I had one student who was at the airport and her plane was delayed, I think, and the whole time she just kept practicing her shimmy, and afterwards, her shimmy was fantastic. Even at work, I had another student who would always do her shimmy while she was doing her photocopying, which I think got a lot of comments from her colleagues, but again, perfect shimmy. So make sure that you find any excuse you can, any time you can, just to practice. Now, you will notice with my shimmy that from here down, I'm very, very relaxed. And it's important that you're relaxed because, you see, if I tighten up, my shimmy's lost, it's a lot smaller. So just relax into it, keep your heels grounded while you're learning, and let everything shake. You want everything to wobble so that you can keep your shimmy going. The other thing is from here up, I'm very tall, very straight. And this is important because then when you go into your layering techniques, you need to be able to separate the different parts of your body so that you can move them separately. Now, with your basic shimmy as well, you might find that you get a bit tired, your muscles get a bit sore. So one thing that I like to do is to come up onto my toes and then just drop down. And when I drop down, just heavy drop, that helps to release everything. Again, posture is really important, not only for your layers, but if you're like this, you can see my shin is kind of stilted. So again, from here down, really relax, here up, nice and tall. Good, so I hope you've enjoyed this video and some of my tips on the basic shimmy. If you have any other tips, please comment below. I'd really love to hear them. Or if you're having any issues with your shimmy that you think other people could help with, please also comment below. I'm going to be releasing video series, as I said, on complicated Egyptian shimmy layers starting next week. So please subscribe if you'd like to see them. They're really, really fun moves and I'm sure you'll enjoy them. So, happy shimmying, and thank you for watching.